In mythology, rains in India was a time to welcome a wind of change, say prayers, and make offerings for one's honest desires. In history, the word monsoon was coined for India by the British Raj because of the astounding variety of rain the whole of India receives. Monsoon brings with it a cause for celebration, and across the landscape of this bustling subcontinent, the celebrations take different guises, each as unique in form as in purpose.
Festivals are a very integral part of India, and monsoon or Sawan, which is considered to be the most auspicious time of the year, is when most of our festivals and fairs are organized and celebrated. Monsoon is celebrated in India in many colorful ways. There are rituals and traditions that are specific to every state in the country. So, for example, there's Tej that's celebrated in Bihar, UP and Rajasthan, in fact most of northern India, and there is Onam that's celebrated in Kerala. Monsoon is typically associated with just rain, but that's not the case in India. For example, when people are celebrating Onam in Kerala, they associate it to harvesting, or when Tej is celebrated in northern India, it's associated with fertility. And monsoon also falls right after a few months of scorching heat. So people are also celebrating the respite that they're getting from that.
For 2,500 years, families have gathered to take part in the largest almsgiving ceremony of the Buddhist year. Kathina occurs at the end of the Vassa, the monsoon. During this three-month retreat, the residents of the monastery are obliged by their ruler not to travel unless absolutely necessary.
As the legend goes, 30 bhikkhus were travelling with the intention of spending Vasa with Gautam Buddha. But unfortunately, Vasa had already begun before they could reach him. And according to the guidelines laid down by the Buddha, he had said they should not be travelling during the rainy season because unintentionally they might harm the crops or the insects. And as a result, they had to stop.
बरसात आने से पहले सभी साधुओं एक निश्चित स्थान पर एकत्रित हो जाते हैं और साधना में लग जाते हैं भगवान बुद्ध की साधना करने लगते हैं साधना में लग जाते हैं
Afterwards, the Buddha rewarded the monks and demonstrated a way to practice sharing and generosity. Previously, a lay disciple had donated a piece of cloth to the Buddha. The Buddha gave this piece of cloth to the group of monks and told them to make a robe. And then this robe should then be presented to one of the monks. A frame called kathina was used to spread the robe while it was being made. This is how the almsgiving ceremony of kathina has evolved.
ये कठिन चीवर दान का एक स्वरूप है, एक सिस्टम है, नियम है, जो सारे लोग बोधि वृक्ष के नीचे बैठ करके भगवान बुद्ध को आराधना करते हैं और जो उपासक होते हैं वो साधुओं को अपना इच्छा पूर्वक जैसे वस्त्र का दान करते हैं, द्रव्य दान करते हैं, रुपये पैसे के दान देते हैं, इसी को हम लोग कठिन चीवर दान कहते हैं।
The Kathina festival brings together the preachers as well as the followers under one roof. While the preachers, the Buddhist bhikkhus, end a 3-month long retreat at the monastery, the followers descend at this ancient site to bid farewell to the monks who will now continue their journey in spreading the teachings of the Buddha. Donating the yellow robes is considered to be a good deed or kushal kamma. Kathina, the word literally means hard, connoting stability and durability. So, kathina is not just about cloth, it is also about firm commitment to monastic life.
संस्कृति में शिव और पार्वती आदर्श पति पत्नी माने जाते हैं।
According to Hindu mythology, Parvati loved Shiva. Being an ascetic, Lord Shiva was not aware of her. Parvati performed penance on the Himalayas for many years, and finally Shiva took notice of her. Then, Lord Shiva came to know about her love and devotion towards him and agreed to marry her and be her husband for 108 consecutive births. Kesariya Balam
Avoni. वो लोग यही कामना करती हैं विवाहित स्त्रियां कि हमें शिव जैसा पति हमारा हो और कुमारी की शिव जैसा मिले भविष्य में।
In modern etymology, Tej is called Haryali Tej as the date of the festival falls in the Savan or monsoon month when the surroundings become green. Greenery in Hindi translates to Haryali. In the state of Rajasthan, a festival centered on the marital wishes of women, unmarried girls fast during the Haryali Tej festival, similar to how Parvati fasted for her one true love. Meanwhile, the married women fast as well, so that their husbands embody the qualities manifested in Lord Shiva.
She prayed for a husband like Shivji in every life, and that's how it started. And it's been 300 years since our family has been doing this and celebrating Tej.
The two-day festival begins with the female members of the royal family paying obeisance to the idol of Tej Mata, or goddess, in the Janani Deori, or palace of the women folk.
Since I was a child, I've been, of course, being a part of the puja that we perform on the day of Tej, the 2 days of Tej, as well as the procession.
This is followed by the ladies carrying the idol into the Takte Ravan.
And puja is performed here of the Tij Mataji, and then she goes into with this really grand procession into the walled city, and so that's how it's done. That's how I've seen my family praying, and my mother before that, my grandmother, and of course it signifies the day when married ladies pray for the long lives of their husbands, and also unmarried girls in Rajasthan.
The tradition of the goddess being taken out on a procession dates back to the 18th century. The goddess's procession, which begins at the palace and ends on the street of the walled city of Jaipur, is one of the biggest highlights and tourist attractions during this festival. As the goddess makes her way out of the palace, the Nishani Hathi, or the symbolic elephant stationed at Tripoli Bazaar, also starts moving towards the main thoroughfare of the city. The Nishani Hathi is accompanied by decorated camels and horses. The Bhog Ki Kavar, or the people carrying the offerings made to the goddess, follow behind.
भोग की कांवड़ के पीछे माता जी को उठाने वाले साथ में माता जी के चारों तरफ घूमर घुमाते हुए लोग भी चलते हैं जो कि पर्टिकुलर एक फैमिली से होते हैं और ट्रेडिशन के हिसाब से हर साल उसी फैमिली से लोग आते हैं जो कि उस घूमर को घुमाते हुए चलते हैं
The traditional dancers or ghumars with their colorful skirts move along with the goddess's procession who is covered in a canopy. As the sounds of the morcha, kartal, manjira, dholak and folk songs rent the air. Fire eaters, men dressed as camels and women dressed in colourful clothes put up a spectacular view. Large crowds line the streets, eager to watch the colourful procession.
त्यौहार को देखने के लिए करीब 20 से 25,000 विजिटर हर बार यहाँ पे इकट्ठे होते हैं जिनमें इंडियन विजिटर्स भी होते हैं और फॉरेन विजिटर्स भी यहाँ होते हैं और वो लोग बहुत एक्टिवली इन सब में पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं
While the common goal of praying for a successful married life brings the women folk of the Rajasthani community together, it is not only about fasting, but also about merrymaking and celebrating sisterhood. Kerala is the only state in India that welcomes the monsoon twice in a year. The first of these rains marks the beginning of a new harvest and the celebration of the oldest known tale of human history. The eternal battle of good and evil rages in all our fields. The Malayali festival of Onam has its roots in this never-ending battle. In mythology and folklore, it is believed that Kerala was once ruled by a demon king and people were rescued from this rule by Lord Vishnu.
यहाँ एक राजा हुआ करते थे जिनका नाम महाबली नाम था तो वो एक्चुअली असुर राजा थे वो प्रजा काफ़ी उनसे प्रभावित थे उनको मानते थे तो ऐसा हो गया कि भगवान को पूछना या पूजा करना ऑलमोस्ट कम हो गया कि यह भगवान से या देवताओं को बर्दाश्त नहीं हुआ तो उन लोगों ने विष्णु से मिलके तो विष्णु वामन के रूप में यहाँ पर आए महाबली की खासियत थी कि जो भी उनसे कुछ मांगा जाए तो कभी किसी को मना नहीं करते थे। तो जब वामन जी यहाँ पर आए तो उस टाइम उनका पूजा चल रहा था यहाँ पर। वामन उनसे 3 गज जमीन मांगा, 3 पैर 3 स्टेप्स।
वामन रूप ऐसा एक पाव इधर भूमि में रखा था, एक पाव आकाश में रखा था, तीसरा पाव जगह नहीं है, तीसरा पाव महाबली बोला मेरा शहर में पड़ो।
With his third foot on the Mahabali's head, Lord Vishnu, in his avatar of Vaman, pushed him into the earth and sent him to Patal, a place just above Nark or hell according to Hindu mythology. However, for all the good that he had done, the demon king was granted permission to visit his people once every year. That day marked the beginning of Onam celebrations. The main aspect of this 10-day festival is the Vallam Kali, or the boat race held at the Punnamada Lake near Alappuzha. Boats of various sizes and shapes dot the waterfront, but the Chudam Vallam, or the snake boats, are the most visually striking creations.
So these boats date back to 14th century Kerala, where during a war, King Dev Narayan ordered the construction of these boats that were called Chundan Vallam. So the best carpenters of the time were commissioned to do this. And the patterns and the traditions that they followed are followed till today. So which means that the making is about 650 years old. The making traditions are about 650 years old. Now these are not ordinary boats, you know. They are built to certain measurements. They are 100 feet long. They can accommodate only 150 men. So these boats are treated as the deity. And only men with bare feet are allowed to go on board. No one else is allowed to touch them. Each boat represents a village. So these are beautifully, vibrantly decorated boats. Green, scarlet umbrellas is what you will see, what stands out. The number of umbrellas denotes the affluence of the family to which each boat belongs. Besides the umbrellas, there are coins and tassels that are used to, you know, to enhance the view of the boats.
The snake boat race became an intrinsic part of the Vallam Kali in 1972. Since then, they have become one of the biggest tourist attractions. Decorated with golden lace, a flag and umbrellas, the snake boats always move in pairs to the robust tunes of the Vanchi Pattu, sung by the oarsmen who look resplendent in their turbans and mundus. The Vanchi Pattu is a traditional Malayali poem of the boat oarsmen. The most famous poem, Kuchela Vrittam Vanchipattu, tells the story of Kuchela and Lord Krishna's exemplary friendship. Pulikali, or the tiger dance, is held in Thrissur. Dressed in the guise of a tiger or leopard, a number of male performers dance to the beats of traditional music instruments like the udukku and thakkil. Continuing with the theme of good and evil, this 200-year-old ritual is an enactment of the play between the hunter and the hunted.
The origin of Pulikali can be traced to 200 years back, when Raja Ram Varma ordered this dance form to be included in Onam to reflect the macho aspect of his forces. Now, if you look at it, it not only reflects the macho aspect since it's the tiger dance, but also the femininity through the vibrant colors that the painters paint their body with.
The process of getting into the guise of a tiger is a long and complicated one, which takes close to 7 hours. Dispelling the divisions of regular society, the secular character of Onam is peculiar to this land, where unity has always coexisted with diversity, especially during this festival when people come together to celebrate this annual proverbial return of the king.
Thousands of spectators line the streets during the snake boat race and the tiger dance. Well, the viewers dance themselves, they cheer the participants. It's a sight to vie for.
Festivals and their celebrations have been giving communities their individual identities since time immemorial. The song, dance, costumes, events, and numerous other things are carried down from generation to generation. The festivities have enamored millions to travel a great distance to witness the grandiose yet grounded nature of these celebrations. India houses some of the most enthralling cultures in the world, and every year, many of them come out to play during the rains. The heavens, pregnant with the expectation of many millions, shower upon them a relief from the heat of the summer, paving the way for a rejuvenated finish to the year and an inspired beginning to the preparations for the next monsoon.